Hello friends, welcome to this LNW tutorial. And this tutorial I will discuss with you in the series of managing local users and group. In the last video I will discuss with you with the two files. One is a password file and shadow file, and how do we can manage or how you can change or manipulate the file information through the usermod command and password command. In the same series, in this video I will discuss with you the group shadow file and password file, manage and manipulate the user, and along with the ch command or ch, which very similar to the password command. So in this video I will discuss for the chh command, and some other I will discuss for the including of files which use in the series. For review, for the last video, this is the link, tutorial link, which you can go over there. And you want to find this the same link, you just join our Telegram channel. It's telegram.me or lnwtutorials. You just go on the Telegram and search the lnwtutorials and join there. And over there, you can find the same PDF file. So friends, without wasting the more time, let me start here. Now I'm just going on my VM machine. Here's a VM machine I have just opened here. Just let me go full screen, and I just open the terminal. Okay. Let me increase the font of the terminal. My current working machine is CentOS 8, which is very equivalent to Red Hat 8 and Fedora 28, and is 86 architecture, and kernel version is 4.18. So let me start friends for the group management. Before this, I have to show you the chh command. Just simply type chh and hyphen h. You able to see here some options like hyphen d, hyphen e, h, i, which is used in, which is some switches used to manipulate the information relating to the users. How you can use this, just let me tail of last five records in password file. It have the alias Bob, as you know in the last video, in the last session I have created, and it has the same g shadow file. In the last video I shared the one command, password hyphen s. Suppose I have to look the information of Bob. Just simply type Bob and it will show the detailed information for the Bob. This is the username, it is in lock state, and this is a date when he have changed his password or is created. Sorry. This is the minimum days of password change, maximum days password change, warning date, and this is inactive state. The same information can be seen by using the chh command with hyphen l for the long listing or detail view. So it says last password change on 23rd of 19 as year when it's created or it's set or manipulated, whatever done, but this is the record. At this time password will never expire, user is not inactive, and account is never expire. Same, the minimum days is 0 and maximum days is 999, and the warning days is 7. The same information as in last video I discussed, same it can be changed. Suppose I want to have the change the date, like last password change date, or I just put here the 0 and giving the username Bo. Means immediately it will. Now all the details have changed. Means when I did the password change date, last password changed with 0, means user have to immediately prompt for the password change, and after then once user have changed his password, then record will updated newer. Then I just now I'm setting here the password for Bob. I set it. Now again let me check the for the user. Yes, so last password change date is 25th November 2019 as today, and his password is never expired. Same thing you have made in the like this Bob with a only one user may be specified. Yes, not the 01, this one you have to give, and password will be expired through the password command. Now just check the same thing. So again password must be changed. So password command and chh both are the very similar, just view and you can say just look and feel is different. Like there is, you have to very similar, or just numeric format which little bit difficult to understand, and here it's in a detail view for the user details. So again I'm just set the password here for the user. Okay, now authentication updated. Okay, well again I have it's done. Now you want to like account expire for the user, just make it chh and this is for inactive. How you can see this, like just put here I inactive after 2 days or 3 days. Like Bob has a password and his password has expired, and between the 3 days if it not changed, then his account will be inactive. I just hit enter. Now let me see the same details. Yeah, it's not mentioned here. Then you can just go with the password command and check with the Bob. See here, once the password will expire after 3 days, account will be inactive. So in the some cases chh will be useful, and in some cases password will be useful, but in the most of the scenario, most of the Unix environment, Linux, you always get the password command. In some cases you will not get the chh, but password will be available everywhere. So you just go through the password. You want to change the minimum password, change it as here 0. Just go on the chh command and hyphen m. Suppose I want to set it 5 for Bob. Now let me check with Bob. So it's changed, minimum password change it 5. I want to have the maximum change, just capital M for this and 5. Now check this details. So minimum days is 5 and maximum days be 5. You want to change the warning, just go here and hit the warning, suppose 2 days before, not this one, this. For the warning it's capital W. Means you can understand, for the chh it's easy to remember the switches which you can use. D last change date, I for inactive, L for listing, small m for the minimum days, capital M for the maximum days, and fn w for warning guys. This is some chroot which I will discuss in the later on. Basically it's used to temporarily redirect the user home directory or executing shell in the somewhere other places where it will execute. So I'm not covering here, I'm just moving to our next topic for the group. Now let me just go under my PDF. Yeah, so I covered here these details. Group. What is a group? It's a group with just two or more or any like combination of similar or same kind of things. So it's just a definition for group. But here, once user have created along with group also created, and for this management similar to the users, it has or it needed two files. One is etc group and another one is etc shadow file. So it has the four records for the group file. One is a name, second is the reference for the shadow file, and it is group ID and it is group member. Same in the shadow file, have the username, its password, and here would be its ID, group ID, and here would be member. So let me just jump in my tutorial. Yeah, this is my machine. Just go in full screen. As I said, it would be two files for the group. I just want to see only two. So test and Bob is created, and another one which is required, it is G shadow for the group. Now let me first manipulate for this user. Suppose you have any user and you want to create or you want to add any user to in a group. Suppose I want to create here one user, group add HR or IT, some specific group I have created. Now let me grab HR in group. It has a group ID 1004. I want to have the test and Bob would belongs to HR group. Then how it can do? For this you just go and make user mode hyphen a hyphen g in a group, append in group HR and username is Bob. Now grab HR, Bob is added. Again here I want to add test user along in the HR. It says user test does not exist. Okay, I just edit here the armor and will check the test in the later on. It says user is not exist, maybe user is not created. So just now I'm adding here in the HR group user. I also want to add Amar. Amar is not exist. Okay, let it be go. This is the details for the group and this is my user list. As he said, test is not here and Amar is not here. Yeah, Amar user is not here and test is not here. That's why it's not getting added in the group. Now I'm just clearing the screen and moving here. So now the Bob and user name with the user have added. I want to remove the user. For this, just make it group mode hyphen r no -d for delete. So I want to delete the Bob from HR group. Okay, let me check once. etc group Bob have added. Now you want to remove, so you just use the gpasswd -d. I want to remove the user whom Bob from the group HR. Yeah, it's removed. Now I want to remove the user Bob. Removed. Let me check. There is now not the part Bob and user for the HR. Great. So I have added the user in this and remove. Like suppose you want to manipulate the details from here, as in the user section you have done. For this we have the group mod command and you have the gpasswd command as very similar to user mode and password command. For the similar, suppose you want to change the name of group, so simply type an hr to its new name, and I want to make the hr. Now just grab here hr, it's replaced. You want to make changes for the group ID, then the command is groupmod -g. I want to make it 1005 here. Give the group name. It's done. Now let me check the HR. So UID is replaced. Similarly, it's worked with the gpasswd. It's also used for assign the password for the groups. I have the password HR too. Let me set here the password. It's very similar as you assigning the password for the normal user. Set the password. Great. Now let me see the entries for this one. HR2, for the HR2 I have assigned. Suppose I'm just going under this file. I made the changes and I just remove the entries from here. Means I'm just removing the password as of now. It's done. Means here the thing is empty now. Now I have to look at this HR2 details. I have set the password, but it's not done. Basically, what I want to tell you here, like here, the exclamation means it's locked as of now. Amar is locked, test is locked, and it's blank. Blank denotes here password is not set. So let me finish here. And with the short notes, I'm just again moving on my sheet here. This is the file which you need to know, and it's a just quick overview. Password-s user to look the details of user, and ch-l to the user. Both are the same command, just CHS gives you the details overview, and password is the one line output which you have to understand. ID is what does, like you have the user, and ID does give you the details of user. Like I just tell you ID, I just put in the ID, and it shares UID is 0, GID is 0, group and contacts. The whole detail is gives. Suppose I want to check for the Aman. Let me look in the user. Here user is Bob. I want to check for the Bob. So UID is 1003, GID is 1003, and group is as well 003. So this can be find here, and some details here which you need to know. Once the user have created, some details is comes here, like what the UID and what GID and where, what will the range is. So it definition is have inside in etc login.defs. This is the file where you hold the details is mentioned here, like what would be the UID, from where it will start, and max UID will be UID minimum and maximum for the system accounts. So this is the whole the details with pick from here. This is the basically script for user creations, and according to this user is created. Here one more you have to know, which is defaults file of user ID. Groups will be 100, and by default the home directory will be created under the ham, under the home, and inactive would be -1. Expire is not set yet. Shell by default is given by bash, and all the profiles will copy it from the etc scale here, and by default mail directory or mail spool is created. If you just change here the no, then mail spool directory will not be created. And if you want to give some other shells like SSH and no login, you just define here, and according to that user will get. I will just show you the one example here. I just changing here bash for SSH, and inactive I am setting here the 2. Now I just save the file, and I just tail 1 here. So not this one, look here, the user is by default created in home, and it getting the shell bin bash. I just user add here testing. Now I just grab the details from the same. Now you can see the shell would be this, and what I made the changes, I made the changes for inactive, means inactive would be 0. So you just can be validated here. F1S, and for whom? For Bob. As you can see, it's threaded because I have manipulated. Alice is earlier one, so I just compare with Alice. It's -1. I just have created one user testing. So here is 2. So you want to manipulate, or you just want to make the changes like it's will create according to you, and what will be rights, what will be permission it will get after the user creation, so you can manipulate the similar one. I just was packed for the default configurations. Now, just now I'm ending here the friends, and I will meet you in the next section. In that section I will discuss with you like some these details and how you can create the scripts, means how you can create the users in a script, and how you can you have to requirement for the create the bulk user, then how you can create it. So I will meet you in the next letter. Thanks for watching. Have a great time.